All right, hi you guys, it's your girl Zan. Let's get started. You're gonna start off with freshly washed and blown out hair. Check out that growth. All right, so I'm going to start with sections. I'm going to do 5 sections, 3 in the front, 2 in the back. And I will be doing free parting, so I'm not caring what the parts are looking like. All right, materials, you're gonna need a comb, rat tail preferably, scissors, clips of course, beeswax, I'm gonna use black, it doesn't matter either way, edge control is important. All right, nail glue, not hair glue, but nail glue. You're gonna need a couple of those. And of course your Freetress hair. I'm using loose wave and your Marley hair. I got 2 packs black and 4 packs of the number 30. All right, and so we're gonna start off with a section. I'm doing 3 parting, like I said. I'm just gonna take the edge control and I'm going to go around the section. And this is to gather the hair together so that you don't grab any flyaways. And then I'm going to use the beeswax for the ends of my hair. And this is just going to protect my hair underneath the dreads. All right, so starting with the Freetress hair, we're just gonna take some of the hair. All right, and then we're going to begin to braid down the section. You don't wanna do this too tight, because once you begin the wrapping part, it will get tighter and you do not want that much tension. All right, and so I'm going to turn the braids into a twist. And then you're going to twist each strand as well as twisting them around each other. Pay attention to the way that I'm doing it. It's important. All right, because that ensures that you're locking the twist in and they will not come unraveled doing them this way. Now, if you do not twist the 2 strands and you just twist down, it'll come unraveled for sure. And the reason I'm starting it off with the braid is to lock it in, and then I do the twist because it's faster than just braiding all the way down. And again, take the edge control around the section, beeswax on the end for the protection of your hair. All right, I want you guys to pay attention to the way that I begin to twist the hair. And again, do not braid too tightly to this gap. You want to make it loose, because once you start to wrap, there will be a lot of tension. Okay, can you see there how I'm twisting each strand as well as twisting them around each other? All right. And this is faster than just braiding down for me. Maybe braiding down is faster for you. Either way, you'll get the same outcome. So if you prefer to just braid down, that is okay as well. All right, so I just wanted to show you guys that I pre-section off my sections with the edge control to help it go faster. You don't have to worry about the white. At the end, you can put mousse on there and it'll go right away. Alrighty, so now that you have it all twisted, you're going to begin the wrapping. As you can see, I've already gotten started, but I'm going to demonstrate on the last 3. So you're going to take your Marley hair, your black, your 2 different colors, your black and whatever color you have, mine's is 30, and you're going to cut the black in half, as you can see. Alright, and we're going to start off with the black. We're going to start off by just placing the hair against the twist, like so, and wrapping the rest of the hair around the twist. And you're gonna do it like at least 3 or 4 times at the beginning to ensure that you've locked it in before you begin to move down the shaft. And you wanted to do this tight to make sure that it does not unravel. All right, so we're gonna move from the black into the number 30. And we're just doing the same thing, laying the hair up against the twist and beginning to wrap around. And you wanna continue to wrap in the same direction that you started. And as you can see, the hair that you have laying against the twist is just being hidden underneath the wrapping, and it's creating the lock. All right, this can be a really tedious method. As you can see, I'm really tired right here. I've been at it all night and I'm so over it, but I'm at the end and I'm just trying to stay strong. But you want to make sure that you're doing it tight all the way until the end. That is one of the most important parts of it. You may start off a little slow, but trust me, after doing your whole head, you will get the hang of it and you will begin to be able to move faster. This is like my third time doing these on my own head, so at this point I'm just good at it. All right, so we're at the end. And before you get all the way to the end, you want to grab, this is where the nail glue comes in handy, because this is going to seal in the ends for you. You're just going to place some on the twist on the Fritri's hair there and just continue to wrap the Marley hair down and around where you've put the glue. And then we're just going to palm roll it on up, and that's it. And it's important to have the nail glue instead of hair glue, because the nail glue dries clear and it's just going to make it look really seamless. All right, so I'm just going to demonstrate that again for you guys on these next two. Again, you're going to cut the Marley hair for the black in half. And depending on how much root you want or how much of the black you want, you just continue to wrap down further. So if you want more of the black, you'll just wrap it down further. And don't forget, you're going to twist at the root at least 3 or 4 times before moving down the shaft, because that is going to lock in the lock and make sure that it doesn't come unraveled. Place the hair against the twist and just begin to wrap around. Simple. It's really a super easy thing to do once you do it. Once you've gotten everything and you start to do the process, you'll see that it's not hard at all. The hardest thing is time. It's time consuming for sure. This took me about 7 hours. But of course I took breaks. I ate. I watched hella shows. You know, so whatever you gotta do to stick with it. Alright, this is really important. So you see how I'm running out of hair here and I haven't gotten all the way down the twist? It's just as simple as grabbing another strand of the Marley hair, placing it against the twist, and beginning to wrap on down. And it's literally that simple. I'm telling you guys, you can do this. It's really not hard at all. Right, so you're just going to cut off that excess hair. All right, and get your nail glue, put it on the twist there, and just continue to wrap around. Home roll, and you're done. It's really that simple. All right, and I'm on the last one here, and as you can see, I'm just demonstrating again how you would add extra hair if you ran out before you got to the end of the twist. And it's really easy, guys. Once you get the hang of it, it's really nothing to it. The hardest part about it, again, like I said, is just the time. It's just really creating the time to sit there and just get it all done. I remember my first time I did it in like 2 days. I just did the twist part one day and the wrapping the next. Alrighty, and that is it, you guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you like the look.